Welcome back to my Road to Completion Guide for Elden Ring. This is episode 4. If you picked up the gold scarab during episode 3, you can equip it now. Buy Rotten Breath and Grail's Roar from the Dragon Communion Shop. Rotten Breath will help us kill most bosses, and the other spell will give us credit toward a trophy. Defeat the dragon outside for a ton of runes. Remember to use a gold pickle foul foot just before the dragon dies to maximize the amount of runes we get. We are killing this boss strictly for runes, so if you have trouble, skip this fight and farm the runes later in the episode. The strategy is fairly simple. Cast Night Maiden's Mist, then ride back to the cliff to avoid the dragon's attacks. Hold down R1 to charge the spell to increase the damage radius. You can tag the boss with Rock Sling, but you need to be careful because the animation leaves you open to attacks. check the nearby coffins for more golden runes. Fast travel back to Bestial Sanctum. Level Vigor to 14 and Intelligence to 40. If you lack the runes, push Intelligence as high as possible and forget about Vigor for now. Defeat Blackblade for more runes. Once again, use a gold pickled foul foot just before it dies to maximize the amount of runes we get. Cast Rocksling to start the fight, then crouch behind the column inside the chapel. It's possible to stand behind the column, but there's a rare chance his projectile will clip you, so crouching is the safest play. The goal is to bait him back to the door so we can deal damage with Night Maiden's Mist. You can choose to bait him first and then cast the mist, or take the opposite approach. I'll show both methods. level faith to 15. Kill the NPC at the back of the chapel with the same strategy we used to take out Blackblade, except this time we'll go outside to avoid the projectiles. This enemy drops an ancient dragon smithing stone, which we'll use later to level up equipment. Fast travel to Fort Ferrith. This fight is entirely optional and will not void any trophies. We're strictly fighting this enemy for more runes. The strategy is to fire off Night Maiden's Mist, then cast Rock Sling 3 times. When the boss challenges us, retreat to the Spirit Spring and use the cliff for safety against his projectiles. In the meantime, we'll be doing additional damage with Night Maiden's Mist since he has to pass through it to get to us. If you're lucky, he'll move underneath the cliff and you can cast Rock Sling 3 more times before he fires off more projectiles. Fast travel to Farum Great Bridge. Level Vigor to 18 and Arcane to 12. If you like the runes to level up both stats, focus on Arcane instead of Vigor. This fight is entirely optional and will not void any trophies. We're strictly fighting this enemy for more runes. Once again, let's use a combination of Rock Sling and Night Maiden's Mist to kill the dragon on the bridge. This boss has a crazy amount of range with his fire breath attacks, so the trick is to cast Night Maiden's Mist and ride away as fast as possible. If we get lucky, the dragon will lock himself on the bridge under the cliff and we can spam Rock Sling for additional damage. I'll showcase both strategies during the fight. Remember to use a gold pickle foul foot to maximize the amount of runes we get just before the boss dies. Pass time until morning to avoid the boss on the bridge, then level up mine to 23. If you lack the runes to level up mine to 23, don't worry about it, because I'm about to show you the very first farming spot in the run. The enemies between here and the next side of Grace are very easy to kill, plus they drop a lot of runes, especially if you have the gold scarab. Use this opportunity to make sure you have the following stats: Vigor 18, Mind 23, Endurance 11, Strength 11, Dexterity 14, Intelligence 40, Faith 15, and Arcane 12. It's okay if your stats are higher, just make sure you meet these thresholds. All you have to do is farm the enemies between here and the next side of Grace, and then fast travel to the Ferrum Great Bridge and repeat the process. This is also a great opportunity to go back and get the Gold Scarab if you didn't get it before. After you have the correct character stats, activate the Side of Grace past the bridge. Use the Spirit Spring to reach the golden runes on the cliff. Grab the memory stone from the top of the tower. Fast travel or ride back to the previous Side of Grace. Memorize the following spells: Night Maiden's Mist, Rock Sling, and Rotten Breath. past time until nightfall to make the boss appear. Equip the claw mark seal so we can use rotten breath. Jump to the spot I show in the video and use a combination of all our spells to defeat the boss. Rotten Breath will inflict Scarlet Rot, which gives us damage over time. Night Maiden's Mist gives us additional damage each time he rides into it, and we can spam Rock Sling anytime the boss is still. Just remember that we have to use the Claw Mark Seal to cast Rotten Breath, and it can take a few attempts to inflict Scarlet Rot. If you tap the R1 button, you'll spew out Rotten Breath one time, but if you hold the button, you'll cast it twice. Unlike the previous bosses, we do not want to use our Gold Pickle Foulfoot this time around. Fast travel to the Castle Morn Rampart side of Grace. Level Mind to 24 and Endurance to 13. Buy one stone sword key from the merchant.
Buying or selling?
Follow the path and grab the sacred tear from the church. Travel south to activate the Site of Grace in the catacombs. My name is Exonovant, and I'll see you in the next one. Be good.